I did bring mine because mine's in the ground at home.
I see. Okay, it's in the ground. You mean it's very plant. Dead?
Well, it looks like it's dead, but it shows signs of life. It's a rhododendron.
Yes. All right. Would you like to lie down, please, Jan?
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye. All right, Jan. Tell me what happened.
Well, it was about 7 years ago. My daughter was a month old, and I went looking for a perennial plant.
Yes?
And I thought I'd like a rhododendron, a nice big rhododendron.
A rhododendron or rhododendron?
Dumb or drum? Anyway, so I know that you can't buy them fake, so I started with a small plant.
Sure.
And I took it home and I planted it.
So it's a postpartum rhododendron.
Yeah. So my plant, 7 years later, is still the same size as it was.
Is the child, has it grown? Well, then you're ahead of the game.
But it's not dead because it still has fringe green little tiny bits of growth on the top. So there is, and I'm not sure I would feel guilty if I chopped it up and put it into the stove.
Yes, and you should feel guilty by chopping up, putting it in the wood stove.
But
the hard
part is the little bits of fringe that grow. There are little bites that come out of it from
something is eating it.
Something is eating it.
Well, very often I think that have you dreamed about it? Have you had any interesting dreams about your rhododendron?
No.
That's too bad, because I really can't think of a single clever thing to say to
my plant.
I guess it's just sometimes parting is very, very sorrowful for all of us, and I think that if it were me, I'm afraid that I would just take the spade and dig it up and throw it out. And understand that these are sometimes psychologically that you have to say, because it's not funny, Jan.
No, it's not.
That you sometimes just have to say goodbye to plants that are not doing well. Mm-hmm. It's sad. And remember, it's just a plant, okay? It's not that important, to tell you the truth.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Dr.
Jan.